You guys have requested a part 2 on how to increase Fortnite's FPS on Mac, so that's what we're going to do. If you haven't watched part 1, stop this video and watch part 1 first. The link to the previous video is in the description, or you can access it from the card on screen now. The video you're watching now is more of an extension on the first episode. To follow along with this guide, make sure your Mac is running macOS High Sierra and was released from 2012 and above. Macs before 2012 don't support Metal, and Fortnite requires Metal to run. With all that out of the way, let's get this second guide started. I've got two methods to either increase FPS slightly or to avoid crashes whilst launching Fortnite. First, let's add an additional command line argument to Fortnite. To do this, open the Epic Games Launcher and click on the Settings tab. From here, go down to Manage Games and open the Fortnite tab. Click on the additional command line arguments. Enter in the following command, which can be found in the video description. This command will make sure your Mac is using all of its resources when running Fortnite, setting the game at high priority. Try launching Fortnite and see if you have more performance. Next, we're going to open Fortnite via another method. To do this, go to the Finder icon, right-click it, and then click Go to Folder. Paste in the following directory, which you can find in the video description, and hit Go. From here, open the Epic Games Launcher Mac-Shipping file. This will open the Epic Games Launcher. Try to open Fortnite now. I should warn, if you close this window, it will close the Epic Games Launcher, so just ignore it. You might just find this opens the game correctly, avoiding crashes, for example. It might not work at all, but it's worth a go. In the first episode, we edited some files using the GameUserSettings file, and we're going to edit a few more lines today. Okay, let's do it. Find the Finder icon in your dock, right-click it, and then click Go to Folder. Enter in the following command and hit Go. This command is also in the description. With the folder now open, find Game User Settings. Before we do anything, make a copy of it, anywhere on your Mac, just in case you want to put the settings back to how they originally were. Now to open this file, right-click it, then click Open With, then click Other. You should see a box now with all your installed applications. Find and open Text Edit. We're going to change a few small things here. First, find Discrete Resolution Quality equals and change it to 1. Now find Scalability Groups and put everything to 1. You can leave resolution quality equals alone, as we changed that in the previous video. Okay, we're done here. Make sure the settings are like mine and hit the save button. It's important to mention that any changes you make here will be erased if you change the resolution size and windowed mode within Fortnite's in-game settings. One cause of lag is often because of the region you're playing on. Fortnite automatically sets the region you're playing on, but sometimes it isn't correct. Changing it to the appropriate region might just increase FPS slightly. With Fortnite open, go into Settings and go into the Game tab. Find the Matchmaking region and change it to the lowest MS, which also stands for millisecond, or some people call it your ping rate. The lower the MS, the better. Basically, it takes a packet of data to travel from you to the host of a server, if that makes sense. So changing it to the right one will hopefully increase your FPS. For me, I play on Oceania because it has the lowest MS and because I'm from Australia. there are a few apps you might be using on your Mac that are causing FPS drops in Fortnite. The first one is Discord, which a lot of you use whilst playing games. Let's turn off Discord's hardware acceleration. To do this, make sure Discord is open and go up to Preferences. From this window, find Appearance. Now simply turn off hardware acceleration. Discord should automatically restart. The same principle applies if you're running Google Chrome in the background. So let's change it. With Google Chrome open, go into the Settings tab. Find Advanced and turn off Use Hardware Acceleration when available. It's best to relaunch Chrome for this to take effect. Time Machine is a great and powerful service on Mac that backs up your Mac computer daily to an external hard drive. But leaving it on whilst playing games can slow down your Mac. I suggest turning it off when you play Fortnite. To turn it off, you can either eject your external hard drive, or go into System Preferences, then Time Machine, and then turn it off. I will say, only turn it off when playing Fortnite or any other games for that matter. A lot of you might not even back up your Mac, so this method isn't of use to you. But I know some of you out there do, so I thought I'd mention it regardless. And that's it, 5 more methods to increase Fortnite's FPS on Mac. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and check out some of my other videos on how to best play Fortnite on Mac. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.